Y'all read the title. Let's do this. Grab your cup because it's time to spill the anime tea. We're gonna try to fix the ending of Wonder Egg Priority today. So you've probably watched the special episode that Wonder Egg Priority put out, and like me, you probably are also very upset and like disappointed, and we're really hoping that there was going to be more, but you realize that's the end of the series and that is how they chose to end it. So yeah, today we're gonna try to reimagine Wonder Egg Priority to see if we can make a more coherent, better ending for it. This is gonna act kind of like a fan fiction. So we're gonna start off with the very first episode, keep it the same, you know? The Akas, or one of the Akas, is disguised as Little Bug and meets Ai in the street and then gets her introduced to the egg world. Let's continue on with the rest of the story, which I mostly want to keep the same. I want to keep the same beginning of the story because it was so well done, just getting introduced to the entire egg world. I learning about the egg world and the girls and their dreams and, you know, the wonder killers and fighting them off and finding Koito and learning that she can try to save her, and all of that should be the same. Plus, of course, meeting all the other characters. Moving on to the episode where we are introduced to Frill for the first time and we learn all about the Akas and their connection to Platy, the company that Neru owns, and you know, the creation of Frill. So I think in my reimagining of the story, the Akas should have worked for Platy, or, you know, maybe helped create Platy or something, and then some kind of huge difference between the company and the Akas, and they decide to leave. And I think this difference probably should stem from like the fact that they wanted to create Frill. Maybe since the company creates, or you know, it says it works with children with really high IQs, but we learned that Neru was artificially inseminated by one of the members and was kind of created. So maybe the company was like, okay, well, that's the most we'll do. That's the most we'll mess with nature. But the Akas wanted to create a whole actual human being through AI, and they were like, nah, we don't want to have nothing to do with that. And the Akas were like, cool, we're gonna leave and do that on our own in our house. That's how Frill came to be. And Frill's like this culmination of all the things they kind of learned at the company, like about like teenage girls. And maybe they were at the company, they were already researching suicide rates in teenage girls and like what having a high IQ has to do with that and things like that. And that's why they wanted to create Frill. So they made Frill. The same stuff happens, you know, they take care of her for a while, and then one of the Akas ends up getting married, and then they have they're gonna have a baby, and then Frill gets jealous because she's realizing that she is not human. She can't do the same things that the human women can do, like maybe have children or, you know, be with one of the Akas, and then therefore she kills one of the Akas' wives. I don't remember her name. So, you know, Himari is still born, the little girl that they had. Again, the same thing happens where she gets older, she becomes a teenager, and then she gets influenced by Frill to commit suicide. Even though, you know, the Akas threw her in the basement, Frill was still having an effect on their lives. So instead of keeping her in the basement, or what do they do with her? I think they try to kill her or get rid of her or something. Instead of trying to do that, they take her to the company, Platy, that they used to work for, and ask them if they can like handle her because they don't know how to like get rid of her. Like, you know, they come out and say like we didn't know what we were doing, this was too much, it ended up being a total failure, do something about it. So the company takes her in, but instead of getting rid of her, maybe because they can't, like she's too powerful or something, you know, she's an AI, so she can just go into the system. This is definitely a fan fiction that is not well planned out. I'm so sorry. So the company can't even get rid of her. Instead, they try to repurpose her by putting her personality into Neru's little sister. So I'm making Neru's little sister an actual character, unlike the series, which just said that Neru was basically her little sister. Neru's little sister is actually another person that doesn't look like Neru. She's just her own person. Yeah, created through artificial insemination, but maybe something went wrong and she lacks like a personality, and the company's trying to figure out like what to do with her. So gets this personality kind of put into her. She gets Frill's personality put into her, and this caused her to go crazy. And therefore, we learn through Neru that her sister stabbed her and then jumped off the bridge. And I feel like that should be Frill who stabbed her and jumped off the bridge. Again, in saying like she's kind of jealous of like, you know, Neru being a real person, and also her trying to escape or trying to understand what's like how to live and what death is and all of that. and she kind of learns that through being in Nero's little sister. Frill does not, you know, officially die. She's an AI, and again, it's hard to kill her. So she kind of goes back into, like, the system and is able to infiltrate the system that they use to have the girls enter the egg world, which I feel like is some kind of connection between Plati and, you know, the Akkas. Like, maybe they both worked on, like, this creation of being able to put the girls in the egg world. And we see glimpses of her influence through the smaller monsters that are in the series. So not the Wonder Killers. Those should be, like, reserved for the girls that our main girls are trying to save in the egg world. But, like, you know, the Haters and those other little small things probably should also be creations, just like Dot and Hyphen were for Frill in the story. And the Akkas realize this. They realize that this is probably Frill. So that's why they give the girls their little, what are those, like, the little Pokemon things, the little animals that help them and eat the Haters to help them fight Frill and also save the girls in the egg world. And then we get to the episode where Ai confronts herself in the egg world. But before we do, make sure you like this video if you're enjoying it so far. Let me know if I should continue making content like this. This is a brand new type of video. If you like it, please press the like button so I can make more. We're at the episode where we see Ai confronting herself in the egg world to fight Mr. Sawaki, or the version of Mr. Sawaki that Ai creates out of fear. At the end, they save Koito. So when they save Koito, and when each of the characters saves the girls that they're trying to save, I think we should get some kind of visual, like, flashback of what happened to each of the girls. Most importantly, especially for Koito, because it's really important to the story and important for, like, the types of themes that the story was talking about, to see through Koito's perspective what happened with Mr. Sawaki and what happened, mostly because also in the special episode they said, like, they made Mr. Sawaki say what happened with her, and then the fact that, you know, Koito supposedly, like, was, like, obsessed with older men and older teachers and making lies and stories about them, it's weird that a teacher, the male teacher, would say this. I feel like we needed to hear it or see it from Koito's perspective in order to understand it better and for it to kind of come off better, because, you know, if we see it from her perspective, then at least we're like, okay, this was how she actually was, you know, now I understand, like, everything she went through. And even though she wasn't, like, a good person, or maybe she wasn't, you know, maybe she didn't have good intentions, we know what she was going through, rather than hearing it from, like, a teacher who we thought was a predator the entire time. I don't think that was a good move. And then after that, you know, they disappear like they did in the anime. Frill's little minions go out and attack each of the girls, like Dot and Hyphen go attack, you know, Momoe and Rika and Ai. And I think that should stay the same, like, that whole situation, all their fights should stay the same. Like, the traumatizing thing was really interesting, and I think it was good for the story, and I think it was good for each of the girls, because they kind of, like, were feeling themselves the whole time, and then this thing happens where that's out of their control, and then they're kind of scared. It kind of creates this rift in the group. So now that each of the girls have gone through these very traumatizing events, some of them have lost, you know, their pets. They don't ever want to go into the egg world again. They don't want to go, like Momoe and Rika. I'm adding this part in. I believe that I asked the other girls to go and help Neru and figure out, like, what happened with her sister, and, like, be there to help her and probably fight, you know, the minions that Frill has been setting out. They all kind of go to sleep together, because, you know, like in that one episode with Rika, if they fall asleep together, they go into the egg world together, and it ends up being the final battle, and they find out that Frill is actually Nero's sister. So Frill is in Nero's sister's body, but Frill reveals herself that she is actually, you know, Frill, and how she was created, which Ai already knows, because she talked to the Akkas and the Akkas admitted what they did. I don't like the fact that Frill was the reason that these girls took their own lives. I don't think she should have been the reason for that. I think she was responsible for the Akka's wife and the daughter Himari's death. I think she's responsible for that, but she's not responsible for these other girls. That has nothing to do with it, because I feel like that just takes away from all the trauma and actual real things that happened to these girls, and the reasons that they decided to take their own lives. So she has nothing to do with that, but she was trying to infiltrate the dreams and stuff to figure out, like, what it means to be a real person, like, and why, you know, people try to kill themselves, and, like, what's the point of it. And she tried it herself, and she still doesn't understand, like, what it means to be human. We should really explore that aspect, because that would be really interesting and stick to the themes of the show. And especially because, you know, they had this whole relationship with the Akkas, and, like, wanting to be human and them wanting her to be human, essentially. They wanted to create a human. So, you know, like, I feel like that would all mix together well. Anyway, so Frill admits all this while also her Wonder Killer monster, like, emerges. And it's basically, I feel like her Wonder Killer should be a mixture of the Akkas before they turned, maybe after they turned too, I don't know, and Dot and Hyphen. Like, it should be all of them combined somehow to create this crazy Wonder Killer that all of the girls have to fight together in this final boss battle. That would have been really cool. Like, seeing all the girls fight together would have been awesome. We only really got to see Rika and I work together to fight. Where was our final boss battle, man? Like, I was waiting for it. So yeah, they all work together. They're able to take down the Wonder Killer. And they also try to, you know, help Frill. Because they're like, I feel like I would step in and be like, what can we do to make you feel alive? My battery is dying. Oh my god. Oh, I gotta pause. But yeah, I steps in, tries to save Frill, or offers some kind of way to save her. Or maybe says that the Akkas can try to, like, create another body for her or something. But Frill decides for herself that she doesn't want to be alive anymore. Like, everything she's kind of been through was a negative experience for her, and she decides not to be alive anymore, which I think would be really sad, but I feel like would match with the theme of the show, you know, girls taking their lives and then us understanding why she may not have wanted to live. Like, she was an unnatural creation and she didn't want to, like, continue on because she would never truly understand what it means to be alive or what it means to be, like, a real girl. Our main girls, they go and they talk to the Akkas, and, you know, everyone learns the truth about, like, who Frill was and what happened and what Plati is and all of this stuff and what the egg world is and all that. And the girls also confront them about, like, what will happen to their friends that they saved. I think the girls that they saved should continue to not exist in their world. Koito and the others are gone in their world, but they exist in the parallel worlds, and that should be the introduction to the parallel worlds, the kind of conclusion for the parallel worlds. All of the girls walk away from the egg world, like, they don't want to be involved in the experiment anymore, they don't want to have anything to do with it, and I think the Akkas should, you know, shut down their stuff, and Plati should shut down as well. I think Neru probably will close the company, you know, since she's, like, she runs it. And I got rid of Kotobuki because I didn't understand why they even introduced her character. I guess because of the parallel worlds thing, but I mean, I just felt she was so unnecessary, and the only reason they kept her around is because in the special episode, they said that she was the one who created Neru, who was an AI, and was a duplicate of her sister. It just felt so unnecessary, like, just an extra thing we didn't need. So even though Kotobuki was a beautiful character and I loved her character design, I feel like we do not need her. We did not need her in the story. Yeah, after they, you know, interact with the Akkas, and the Akkas probably decide to just not continue living anymore, because what's the point if they're just doing research? I don't know. I feel like something needs to happen to them. Some kind of sacrifice needs to be made for them, because they're just wreaking havoc all over the place. But the girls go on to live their regular lives, and I want to see each of them attempting to live a regular life. So I want to see Momoi trying to act more girly despite all the things, you know, everything around her trying to tell her that she's more masculine. I want Rika to come to terms with, like, living, hopefully stop cutting herself, talk with her mom more, going back into her life more confidently. And I want to see Neru going off to do some other great things with her brains. Maybe she starts her own company that's separate from Plati. That would be cool, because she already made a company and she has a huge IQ. She can definitely go make another one that maybe studies something else related to girls, or maybe it also studies suicide rates in girls just in a more humane way. That could be a thing. And then with Ai, of course, I want to see her, since she was already going to school towards the end of the series anyway, I want to see her either, like, try to join a club or try to interact with other girls or other people, and try to make friends with them. And, like, see her, like, rev up and, like, be confident in herself like she was whenever she was in the egg world, like her little, you know, run thing where she's about to go run and, like, preparing herself. I want to see that, but her stepping into the real world again. Because the thing I hated the most about the special episode ending was the fact that, you know, she was just so happy going back into the egg world. Like, I feel like they learned all they needed to learn through that world and through the process of trying to save their friends and everything they went through with Frill and the Akkas and everything. And I feel like they now need to separate that and go back into their real world and deal with their real issues, especially Ai, because she was avoiding it the entire time. And it wasn't until towards the end that she was beginning to confront it and face it head on. And I feel like her being like satisfied and knowing like what happened to Koito, like what actually happened to her through her vision, through her words, not Mr. Sawaki's, will help her like continue to move on in her life. And the whole show introduces concepts and theories and traumas and things of these girls that could have been explored way more. But of course, because of whatever happened with the studio and the creators of the series, we couldn't get that. So we're just left with our own imaginings. Maybe there'll be a reboot one day and they'll try to recreate the series. Who knows? I would love that, honestly, just to see if it get another chance. Must have been so difficult to try to create the series with all of the pressure and the creative differences and everything that went on behind the scenes with the creators and the publishing company for the show that led to, you know, some not so great things about the series, like the recap episode in the middle of the series and the recap slash special episode that we got at the end. Yeah, I super appreciate the writer, Shinkai Nojima, and the director, Shion Wakabayashi, for everything they created, and everyone who worked behind the scenes on the animation and on the story and everything, and all their hard work. I personally just was unsatisfied with the special episode and with the kind of with the last half of the series, and I feel like I just wanted to make like a fan fiction or reimagining of how the story could have gone with what we were given in the series. But yeah, that was my interpretation or my reimagining of Wonder Egg Priority. How would you reimagine the series? Let me know in the comments down below. And if you want to learn more about Wonder Egg Priority and maybe the symbols and stuff that's going on, I made a whole other video that you can go watch on my channel. So make sure you watch that. Thank you so much for watching this video and sticking around. My name is Phoenix. This has been the NYT, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.